Okay, so we need to learn basics of Fourier series in order to do analysis for any voltage waveform or the current waveform in power electronics. And whatever I'm going to teach in Fourier series, if you remember the exact equation for a particular waveform, then it becomes really easy for you to approach sums. Okay, for example, the first question that we are going to see is this rectangular waveform, whose limits is from plus VDC to minus VDC, and the time period is equals to 2 pi. That is, T is equals to 2 pi. Since the waveform repeats itself after every 2 pi. All right. Now we know that A naught by 2 is given by 1 by T integration 0 to T f of T d omega t. So what I did is I did A naught by 2, which is equals to 1 by 2 pi 0 to 2 pi f of T d omega t. And An is given by 2 by T integration 0 to T f of T cos of n omega t d omega t. And Bn is equals to 2 by T integration 0 to 2 pi f of T sine of n omega t d omega t. Okay, these are formulas that you learn in signal and system subject. All right, now An is equals to 2 by T. 2 by T is nothing but 2 divided by 2 pi, which is equals to 1 by pi. 0 to 2 pi f of T cos of n omega t d omega t for this signal or the waveform. And Bn is equals to 1 by pi 0 to 2 pi f of t sine of n omega t d omega t. Now when we put n equals to 1, we'll get a fundamental component of frequency f or omega. And when we'll put n greater than 1, then we'll obtain harmonics, which will have frequency 2f, 3f, 4f, and so on. Now V naught is nothing but the fundamental plus the harmonics. We know that from, see, you look at the figure, it starts from 0 until pi, the value of V naught is VDC. From pi to 2 pi, the value of V naught is minus VDC. Now you remember that thing. So V naught is equals to plus VDC from 0 to pi and minus VDC from pi to 2 pi. From the above mentioned formulas, you just put all these values. A naught by 2 is equals to 1 by 2 pi integration 0 to pi VDC d omega t integration pi to 2 pi minus VDC d omega t. Okay, which when you will find, it will turn out to be 0. If you want, I'll do the steps over here. That is, A naught by 2 is equals to 1 by 2 pi integration of VDC d omega t is nothing but like this, VDC integration d omega t from 0 to pi minus VDC. We are taking this whole minus VDC outside here. Integration pi to 2 pi d omega t, which is equals to 1 by 2 pi into VDC. The integration of d omega t is nothing but omega t. It's like this. Integration of d omega t is equals to omega t A B. Let A be the lower limit, B be the upper limit. So it will be, your upper limit is pi minus 0 minus VDC into 2 pi minus pi. This is nothing but pi. So pi into VDC minus pi into VDC, which will turn out to be 0. Now we'll see An is equals to 1 by pi integration 0 to 2 pi VDC into cos of n omega t d omega t pi to 2 pi minus VDC cos of n omega t d omega t. Now since I have shown it here that the integration of 0 to pi cos of n omega t is nothing but sine of n omega t by n 0 to pi. So we got this thing. Okay, now you put the limits, you'll get sine of n pi minus sine 0. Sine of any pi, like pi, 2 pi, 3 pi is going to be 0. Sine of 0 is going to be 0. Minus sine of 2n pi will also be 0, and sine of n pi will also be 0. So we get An is equals to 0. Therefore, An is equals to 0 and A naught is equals to 0. Now you remember this thing. I'll tell you a small point at the end of our solution. Now let's compute Bn. Bn is equals to 1 by pi integration 0 to pi VDC sin n omega t into d omega t minus VDC sin n omega t d omega t with the integration limits pi to 2 pi. Now we know that the integration of sin n omega t d omega t from A to B is equals to minus of cos n omega t divided by n from A to B. See, I took n outside already, okay? I took VDC also outside and pi we already had. So VDC by n pi minus cos of n omega t from 0 to pi in the same way from pi to 2 pi, okay? Now you take minus sign outside, you get cos of n pi minus cos of 0 minus minus plus cos of 2 n pi minus cos of n pi. So what we get is Vn equals to Vdc by n pi 1 minus cos 2 cos n pi plus cos 2 n pi. Now if you put n equals to even, cos n pi will be 1. For example, n equals to 2. So cos of 2 pi is equals to 1, cos of 4 pi is equals to 1, 1 n. In the same way, cos of 2 pi n. So 2, let's say n is equals to 2. So 2 into 2, that is 4. So cos of 4 pi is equals to 1. You can cross check it by your own self. Vn is equals to Vdc by n pi 1 minus 2 plus 1 equals to 0 for n equals to even. For odd, cos of n pi is equals to minus 1. For example, n is equals to 1. We get cos of pi which is equals to minus 1. Cos of 3 pi is equals to minus 1. In the same way, cos 2 n pi is equals to 1. So when we put the values Vdc by n pi 1 minus, you see here we have cos n pi which is minus 1 for odd value, and cos 2n pi which is plus value for odd numbers. So it turned out to be 4 Vdc by n pi for n equals to odd. Now we know that according to exponential Fourier series, V0 is equals to a0 by 2 plus sigma of n equals to 1 to infinity in the brackets an cos n omega t plus bn sin n omega t. We know that a0 is equals to 0 and an is equals to 0 in this particular signal. So V0 turns out to be nothing but sigma of 1, 3, 5 or odd numbers till infinity 4 Vdc by n pi sin n omega t. Now, the question which we had is already over. There is something which I want to tell you. We know that Fourier series can be found only for the periodic signals. Periodic signals means x of t is equals to x of t plus or minus t, which means that after every particular interval of time, it will keep on repeating itself. And the another condition for a periodic signal is that it should exist from minus infinity to infinity. Now in the question, we showed the signal from 0 to infinity. For that signal to be periodic, the same should exist on the left hand side. Okay. Now if you look at this particular area of the signal, you will understand that x of minus t is equals to minus of x of t. Now this thing signifies that this signal is nothing but an odd signal. According to the concepts of signal and system, if there exists an odd signal, then an will always be 0. If there is a periodic signal, then a0 will always be 0. A0 is nothing but the average itself. So we are done with the first question. Hope you understood it.